Hi, I'm Lucy. Today, I will show you the Avalon A320X multifunction test fixture with screen. It does not need to be connected to a computer to view the test results. Just slide the fixture screen. Its accessories include USB cable, used to connect the fixture to a computer for firmware flashing. Gray ribbon cable for connecting hash boards below the 1066 Pro. This ribbon cable is used for connecting the 1066 Pro hash boards, as well as 11, 12, 13, and 14 series hash boards. This is the foot switch, which is handy for controlling the voltage output when measuring chip signal waveforms. Red and black alligator clip power cord connects the test fixture and the hash board, mainly to power the hash board. This is a test clip for shorting the D signal. If we need to flash firmware to the control board, we'll need this ribbon cable for that. Now, let me walk you through the functional buttons of this jig. It has a large touchscreen where we can directly view the test data. The white knob on the left is used to select the ASIC chip model of the hash board to be tested. For example, if the ASIC chip model is A3200, we need to select gear 0 and press it. Each gear represents a different chip model. Notice, there is another gear in front of the C gear, which is used to test the hash board with the A3198 chip installed. After selecting, be sure to press to confirm. The black knob on the right is for selecting the test mode. N is for normal test mode, typically used to check for hash board failures. T is for signal measurement mode, which can also measure domain voltage, boost voltage, LDO voltage, and ASIC chip signal waveforms on the oscilloscope. If we need to short the D signal for troubleshooting, select mode F. These modes are cyclic and have the same function. Here are the positive and negative interfaces. The plus sign means positive, and the minus sign means negative. They are used to connect the hash board to power it. These two are 12 volts powering interfaces. When using a PC PSU, these two interfaces must be connected. This one is the foot switch interface, used to control the fixture to test the hash board. These three are the original PSU interfaces. USB interface, used to connect to a computer for firmware flashing. Control board firmware flashing interface, connect the fixture and control board to flash the firmware. These two are ribbon cable interfaces for connecting the hash board. The black one works for models below the 1066 Pro. The white one is for 1066 Pro, as well as 11, 12, 13, and 14 series hash boards. During repairs, if we need to short the D signal, use this interface. When testing, if the OK light on the left is on, it means the hash board is fine. Otherwise, the NG on the right indicates a fault. The middle light is the power indicator. When the foot switch is stepped on, the light is on, which means that the hash board is powered normally. If the MT light is on, it means that the cable connection between the hash board and the fixture is normal, otherwise it is abnormal. Now, let's connect the related cables. Note that the red alligator clip corresponds to the positive pole, and the black one corresponds to the negative pole. I will use this Avalon hash board for demonstration, with the ASIC chip model A3200. When testing the hash board, A cooling fan is required to cool the hashboard. Then correctly connect the fixture and hashboard. I will first demonstrate the D-signal short circuit method. At this time, we need to select the F gear. Similarly, the plus sign here on the D-signal test clip represents the positive pole. Of course, the red here also represents the positive pole. The minus sign on the other side represents the negative pole. We will measure chip 113 as an example. The black clip goes to the negative pole of chip 113, and the red clip connects to the D signal. Step on the foot switch. During measurement, if the fixture shows that 113 chips are detected, it means that chips number 1 to 113 are all good. If the fixture shows 100 chips, then it means that chips number 1 to 100 are good, and the chips between number 101 to 113 are abnormal. We can use the same method to troubleshoot one by one until we find the problem. Then, I will demonstrate how to test the hash board failure. Since the chip model of this board is A3200, we need to select gear 0 and press it to confirm. The mode should be set to normal, that is, N gear. Then, we power it on and press the foot switch. The measurement result here is no ASICs, which means that the hash board has a fault and needs to be repaired. If it's a good one, it will show information such as its chip number, temperature, domain voltage, and hash rate. Finally, I will demonstrate another function of it, burning the control board firmware. The powering remains the same, and these two buttons do not need to be adjusted. At this point, we need to use ribbon cable to connect the Avalon Universal Control Board. When connecting, be sure the blue cable corresponds to this pin. Connect it like I did. The other end is connected to this row of round holes on the control board. Also use the blue cable as a reference. And insert it in sequence like this. Then use the USB cable to connect the fixture and the computer. During the flashing process, we recommend fix the cable by hand to ensure good contact. After power on, we can see the indicator light on the control board lights up, indicating good contact. Now, let's start flashing the control board firmware. Double-click to open the software. Please note that the port here must be consistent with the computer port to which the fixture USB cable is connected. We can confirm this in the computer's device manager. Okay, they are the same. The baud rate is the same as what I selected, and the speed mode is fast. Then, click here to select the firmware to flash, and click download. Well, the download was successful, which means we have successfully flashed the firmware to the control board. It's very simple and quick. Okay, that's all for this video. If you have any other questions, feel free to contact us or leave a message for discussion. Thanks for watching.